Hey, welcome to another JobSite Live here with RIDGID. We're in Elyria, Ohio. We're excited to have you again. Today we're going to go through all things press tools, including our two new press tools that I know you're really interested in learning more about, the new RP350 and the new RP342 Xl. Today we have Michael Provenzano, our Global Product Manager over pressing, and we also pulled Adam Daniels, one of our territory managers, out from the field in here to help showcase all of our press tools. A few things before we get started. If you have questions, we are going to answer those real time today. So there is a little field along the bottom of the screen. Ask questions as you wish throughout today's presentation. Mitch Barton, who is our Global Director of Pressing, he will be answering those real time. His handle is mitch.barton51, so look for him. If you have questions you want us to ask at the end to Michael and to Adam, feel free to ask the question through the little question icon you see at the bottom of the screen. So click that question, ask it, and we will address it at the end. Today we're going to give away 4 RIDGID Carhartt hats, so stay tuned. 4 lucky winners will be receiving that, and we're going to go ahead and get started. Go ahead, Michael.
Thank you, Becky. So RIDGID brought press technology to the North American market over 20 years ago. Since then, we've developed the most robust line of press tools in the market. They make quick and reliable connections on PEX, copper, stainless steel, and carbon steel. And we've designed them to meet the needs of both service and new installation for residential, commercial, industrial, and marine environments. Now, last time we talked all things rings, actuators, jaws, and attachments. Today we're going to talk tools, but you will see Vega fittings in our presentation today. We partnered with Vega over 20 years ago, and we're two premium brands that have helped our customers make over 500 million successful presses to date. At this point, I'm going to turn it over to Adam to talk about which tool might be right for you.
So when we're talking press tools and we're talking about our press tool platform family, we have 3 different platforms to choose from. First and foremost, we do have our compact press tools. That would be our RP241 and our RP240. Both of these press tools have capacities from 1/2 inch to 1.5 inches on PEX, 1/2 inch to 1.25 inches on copper and stainless steel, and both tools both do 1/2 and 3/4 inch black pipe. Both of these tools are very ergonomic, very small, very, very good use for residential use, light commercial, new installs, our smallest family of press tools. Moving up, we do have our standard line of press tools. This is our RP350. This will do a 1/2 inch up to 4 inch copper and stainless, 1/2 inch up to 2 inch PEX, and 1/2 inch up to 2 inch mega press. This is great for all lines of your pressing needs, whether it be new installs, commercial, industrial, marine. And I'll turn it over to Michael to talk about our extended family of press tools.
So our extended family consists of really two tools. You have the press booster here, and you also have the RP342 XL. Now the RP350 and the RP342 XL can press from 1/2 inch to 2 inch PEX, 1/2 inch to 4 inch copper and stainless steel. And when you attach the booster to the 350, both the RP350 and the 342 XL can press from 2.5 inch to 4 inch carbon steel. Now these tools are great for anybody that's doing large commercial work, industrial work, and marine applications. Really, if you're pressing a lot of mega press XL, the RP342 XL is going to be the tool for you. Turn it back to Adam to discuss compact tools specifically.
So when it comes to compact press tools, the reality and the differences is in the grip and what you prefer the most. Both tools have the same size capacities. The difference is in the RP241 is we have a nice inline ergonomic design. The handle is forward facing, so it gives you better balance in your hand. We also have our traditional style pistol grips tool, which is the RP240. So that way you can pick and choose what feels best for you, what is most comfortable in your hands, and what's going to help you get your job done faster and easier and more productive during the day. So, we talked about our different product lines, we talked about the different size materials, different materials that we can press. So we're going to go through here, and then on the RP241, we do have an LED indicator lights on the back. And what this does will give you real time indication on what's going on with your tool. Both of these tools both offer the same LED indicator lights for real-time tool analysis, as well as Bluetooth connectivity. You can connect these tools to your phone or smart device using the RIDGID Link app. And within that app, you can actually track your tool, where it was last connected to your phone at. You can connect it and check your prices, your presses, your cycle count history, how many presses are actually on this tool. So that way you know how many times this tool has been pressed, when it needs to go in for service, and actually show you where your nearest service center is. So on the RP241 inline, we do have the Vega PureFlow PEX draws on here. And across all of our families, we have a simple pin connection that will actually remove and change your heads so you can choose to press whatever material you're pressing. So we'll slide that back in, make sure it's fully locked. Here we have a PEX fitting. We are going to first make sure our PEX is fully inserted. Open our jaws. Make our press in under 5 seconds. Release, and it's that simple. So that is our RP241. Moving over to the RP240 again, same pin style design. Here we have on a set of copper jaws. These do have a 180 degree swivel, so you can swivel this whichever way you want to get into those tight spots, those crawl spaces, those attic joists, to get on a stub out. Again, we have our Vega PureFlow, or our Vega fittings. We make sure they're fully inserted, and we've actually pre-marked this so I know that my pipe is fully inserted into the fitting. Turn my tool on. Again, make sure that my fitting is firmly seated within my jaw, and I can turn this any way I need to. Just like that. And to go over our RP350, I'll turn it over to Michael.
So the RP350 is the latest tool in our latest generation in our standard product lineup. It features, actually before I get into that, I want to mention, so last time we talked, last month, we had this tool available for pre-orders. At this point, I can confirm that we are shipping this tool. And what makes this tool stand out is it features a brushless motor that is capable of over 100,000 press cycles. As a result, we're actually launching this tool with no scheduled maintenance required. Now, this tool also features 360 degree swivel. That's the first in the industry. That is beneficial to get into really tight spaces from a variety of angles. It also features the most advanced LED lighting in the industry. So as I depress the trigger here, you'll see that light come on, and you can see it's incredibly light, bright light, which is great for low light and no light applications. We also have color-coded status indicators on the back here. It's gonna give you a variety of information. One, it's gonna let you know when the tool's ready to use. It's also going to let you know when that tool is connected to Bluetooth. Adam shared with you the functionality of our Bluetooth system. Just like our compact tools, our standard tool here, RP350, has Bluetooth as well. It'll let you know when the battery's low. That's great, so before you get up on that ladder, you can replace that battery so you don't have to come back down. Down here, there's a bolt sensor. That bolt sensor is patented by RIDGID, and what that does is it protects both the tool and most importantly, the user. So at this point, when I squeeze that trigger, this tool does not function when that bolt's not engaged. I re-engage that bolt, and it's ready to function. It also will let you know if the tool is out of temperature range. We have a pretty broad range of temperature, but if it's outside of that range, it will not function. And then, should the tool ever require service, it will let you know right here. This tool ships with in kits with two 18-volt batteries. Those are 2.5 amp batteries. And as a result of those batteries and the power efficiency that you get out of this brushless motor, you are able to press 325 presses on 3/4-inch Type L copper. So again, this is the latest generation of our standard tools. We are now shipping this tool. And right now, I'm gonna make a press on a half-inch mega press fitting here. So again, we've got our fitting. We're gonna close the jaws on the tool. And we've got a nice fast cycle here, you'll see. Just like that, you've got a nice pressed fitting on that carbon steel. Step over here and we'll talk extended tools. So as I said earlier, you can kind of supercharge this RP350 for those applications when you need to press 2.5 inch to 4 inch carbon steel. You can do that by using the press booster and you're ready to go. It simply attaches to the head just like any other jaw, it's just a bit larger. Now if you're doing a lot of Mega Press XL, you can step up to the RP342 XL. This tool is perhaps the most versatile tool on the market. And that's because not only is it compatible with all RIDGID standard series jaws, rings, actuators, and attachments, once you attach this Vega Z3 actuator, you can press from 2.5 inch to 4 inch carbon steel. This tool does have an LED light. It also has color-coded status indicators here. But what makes it unique is its ability to switch from standard to extended and from extended to standard. So at this point, this tool is in extended mode. When I squeeze this trigger here, it's gonna run out just for about 5 seconds. And at that point, I can use the quick switch collar to transition this to standard tool. So it functions with all of our standard series attachments. I can press the release button here to draw those rollers back, and I can then disengage the pin, insert any of those jaws on there, and use it as a standard tool. To transition it back, run the rollers out, switch the quick switch collar here, hit the pressure release button, and now this tool is back in standard mode and ready to use the Z3 actuator to press those large Mega Press XL fittings. Which we'll step over here, throw this on. Now this is a pre-press fitting. We're gonna be pressing this today. So he's just gonna hold it in place until I get the actuator engaged. Once it's engaged, I can make the press. So at that point, that fitting's pressed, and we're ready to go. So, before we finish up today, we want to share one more thing. We've talked tools, and we've talked all of our standard, compact, standard, and extended tools, but we're going to step over here. We're going to show you the Strut Slayer as well.
So, as Michael pointed out, this is our brand new Strut Slayer. This fits on our standard family of tools, and what the Strut Slayer will do is it will cut and shear strut standard 1 5/8 or the shallow 13/16. You can buy this in a couple of different ways. You can buy it with a standard set that goes for a standard 1 5/8. You can buy it with a die set just for a shallow 13/16, or you can buy it with what's called a combo die head. And we actually have the combo die head on here right now, so you can shear standard or shallow strut with the same set of dies. And we're gonna run through this real quick and show you guys a quick strut cut. So I turn my tool on, and what you can do is simply just slide this strut in and through. And that's how it works. I have it slid through. What's nice about this tool is that there is a brace built on the backside. This acts as a support on the strut when you make that shear station. This will give you a clean, square cut every single time with no burrs or no chafes to sharpen off. So we'll slide this through, and we'll go ahead and make sure everything's set up, and we'll make a cut. Just like that, you get a nice, square, clean cut with no burrs. That is the new Strut Slayer. Michael?
Okay, so at this point, we're gonna open up for questions that you may have, and Becky here is going to share those questions with us.
Sure. The first question, can the Strut Slayer cut coated unistrut on the RP350?
I do not know that.
Well, actually, you have to respond to that in the comments. I believe it does not, but we will ensure that we get an answer for that and comment back on that.
Sure. So is the RP241 Bluetooth compatible?
Yes, absolutely. So the compact and standard tools, the RP240, 241, and 350 now, are all Bluetooth enabled.
All right. We have a few more questions. Can I use my old 340 jaws and rings with the new RP350?
Absolutely. We designed the RP350 to function with all RIDGID standard series jaws, rings, actuators, and attachments.
Okay. What gives you the confidence to drop scheduled service?
So we did an enormous amount of testing with this RP350. We tested, ironically, over 350 tools, and we did over 22 million cycles. And in those testing, the vast majority of the tools performed well over 100,000 cycles with that brushless motor before they failed. So we're very confident in the quality of this RP350 tool.
Okay, we have another question about the Strut Slayer. When will I get the Strut Slayer I ordered?
So we have been shipping these tools. We've been on a little bit of a backlog, but I can say that we are catching up. And actually, by the end of this month, we expect to be caught up on orders. So we will be continuing to meet the really strong demand on this tool with shipments over the next, week, months, years, so forth.
Okay. And why and when would I buy a RIDGID RP342 XL versus a new RP350?
So we'll step over here for this one. So the RP350 is a tremendous tool, and it's extremely versatile. If you're in the commercial space where you're doing a half-inch PEX or a half-inch copper, and that's the majority of your presses, you're going to want the RP350. Now, if you're still doing some of that MegaPress XL, that's when you want to get the booster. But if you're doing the majority of your presses as smaller diameter, copper, PEX, even MegaPress, you're going to want the RP350 with the booster. If you're doing a lot of MegaPress XL, 2.5 inch to 4 inch carbon steel, that's when you're gonna want the RP342 XL. Again, they function the same way. You're gonna get the same quality press out of both tools, but this tool is just a little lighter, it's a little easier to handle than our RP350 with the press booster. Okay, so step back over here and we'll close up here. So last month we did review everything, jaws, rings, actuators, and attachments. Next month, join us for a review of the Flex Shaft product. We will be really excited to share that. If you ever have questions about what actuators, jaws, rings go with what tools, you can reference this cross-reference tool. That link is gonna be in our bio. To access that. Should you ever need any more information, you can either contact your RIDGID rep or your distributor rep, or you can go to www.rigid.com/press tools. Thank you very much, everybody, and we look forward to speaking with you next month.